no matter how bleak it looks out there, it's dunya. You're in the lowest. Dunya means the lowest place. A dunya. We're on the bottom. There's only up from here. Really, there's only up. This place, wallahi, all of you, I'll give you sincere advice and myself. This place is designed to break your heart. It was designed that way. If you're looking to be happy in the dunya, you're in the wrong place. If Allah gave you a horrible spouse, you can get out of it. And He might give you another horrible spouse. Or you don't find a spouse and then you're lonely and you wish you were with your horrible spouse, because at least being with him or her, there was somebody to talk to. And then he might make you happy, but you look, how many wealthy people do you know that have a lot of wealth, who have children that are in tribulation, who have sons that are completely wayward, or really, look out there. People are in tribulation. You think you're looking at him because he has a big house, he has nice Mercedes. If you were in his shoes, you might say, I want to be back in my old shoes, even though they have holes in them. Because at least I can sleep at night. In his shoes, I have to take all these pills to go to sleep. Everybody has their tribulations. And it's very rare, people that have happy time, wonderful life, all that, those people are rare, and they're just, I am an ayatillah. That's all they are. But Ibn Abbas said, أصر الدنيا الابتلاء فإذا أنعمكم الله فهي نعمة على نعمة. The foundation of dunya is tribulation. So if you're in ni'ma, which is still an ibtila, but it's easier in some ways, and in some ways it's not, because it's easier to forget Allah when things go well. It's much more difficult to forget Allah when things are difficult. And that's why the Sahaba, because they said, الرخاء لا تعقبها إلا الشدة. When things are easy, they're always followed by hard times. Whereas when things are hard, they're always followed by easy times. So they preferred to be waiting for the ease than to be waiting for the hardship. Because intidhar al-faraj, afdalul ibadah, is a hadith. And it's Hassan. Afdalul ibadati, intidhar al-faraj. The best worship is waiting for the ease from Allah to come when you're in hardship. So if Muslims would just have that perspective, they would realize that if I'm just patient here with all these tribulations, I'm in ibadah. You could just be sitting in your house. And if you're muhtasib with Allah, you're in ibadah. But if you're there complaining and woe is me and everything's horrible and it's doom and gloom and it's all black and it's all dark, Allah will give you more things to complain about. And He'll give you some real things to complain about, because there's a hadith, if you complain about small calamities, Allah gives you great calamities. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا مَوْلَى لَهُمْ. You know, the people of kuffar, they have no Lord. We have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as long as you have Allah, they can't take anything away from you. كُلُّ مَا تَهْوَاهُ مَوْجُودٌ فِي ذَاتِ اللَّهِ. Everything you desire exists with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you have Allah, you have everything you desire. If you don't have Allah, nothing you desire will make you happy. Nothing. It'll all in the end bring you misery. Wallahi. And that's the truth. It's not a lie.